the voice of their angel, the McCanns' Christmas wish that this be the last one without Madeline. They've released a new and highly personal family video in the hope it will trigger a breakthrough in the search for their missing daughter. Also on the programme, Lockerbie remembered solemn moments marking 20 years since Britain's worst terrorist atrocity. And Hallelujah, Hallelujah, the same song takes the top two places on the Christmas chart. Good evening. Kate and Jerry McCann today released a previously unseen home video showing Christmas how they want to remember it, with their missing daughter, Madeline, at the heart of the family. It was the last time they were all together over the festive period, and the video ends with a plea. Help us to make sure we don't have a third Christmas without her. Nina Nana reports now on the McCanns' firm belief that Madeline is still out there.
We know Madeline's face, but this is the first time we have heard her voice.
That was my shoe.
That is your shoe. What colour is it?
These are my shoes.
Are they new?
Yeah.
And what colour are they?
Pink.
Lovely.
And then as her father continues to film her, the three-year-old leaves her younger brother and sister and takes her new pink shoes as she dances around the floor. These are images never made public before. It is a moving appeal from parents who have not given up hope. The video, set to music, shows the last Christmas Madeline had at home in Leicestershire in 2006. Private family moments, from the rough and tumble with Dad, to pictures of Madeline when she was younger, and then a renewed beg for help. As they approach a second Christmas without Madeline, the McCanns say they don't want to go through a third. It has been a grueling 19 months for them. Madeline disappeared from the family's holiday apartment in May 2007. By September, Kate and Jerry McCann were interviewed by Portuguese police and made arguidos, or prime suspects. But after 10 months, the Portuguese closed the case. The McCann's arguido status is lifted. 2 weeks later, case files are released showing Portuguese police were warned there was no firm DNA evidence connecting the McCann's to Madeline's disappearance. The couple say they have yet to find any evidence that Madeline has been seriously harmed, which is why they've now released images they perhaps wanted to keep for themselves. Images of Christmas past from a family desperate for answers. Nina Nana, ITV News.
In other news tonight, a Royal Marine was killed today following an explosion in southern Afghanistan. He was on a routine patrol this morning with the Commando Logistics Regiment Royal Marines in Helmand Province. His next of kin have been told. An argument's erupted between the police officer investigating alleged leaks of government secrets and the Conservatives. Met Police Assistant Commissioner Bob Quick, seen here on the right, says his inquiry risks being undermined by the release of information which he says puts his family in danger. The Conservatives say the claims are wholly untrue. Big price cuts in the run-up to Christmas have failed to get us spending. Latest figures for the past week show an 11% fall in shopping compared to this time last year. And Labour has denied it was considering plans to charge some of Britain's poorest families high interest rates on emergency loans. The government document suggests low-income households could be hit with rates as high as 27%. But ministers say any borrowing from the social fund will remain free of charge. The name of every victim of the Lockerbie bombing was read out tonight in a special service 20 years to the day since the terrorists struck. All 259 people on the Pan Am flight from Heathrow to New York died. 11 others in the small Scottish town were also killed. From Lockerbie, here's our Scotland correspondent, Debbie Edward.
A silence at 7:03, the time 2 decades ago Pan Am Flight 103 blew up over Lockerbie. People in the town gathered for a vigil to remember the lives lost.
Lindsay Somerville, Paul Somerville, Rosaline Somerville.
The flight had set off from Heathrow. At a special service there, the names of those killed were read out. entire families perished.
We have always sought truth and justice. And it's partly because we do that that Lockerbie is not simply a forgotten footnote in history.
It was the Friday before Christmas in 1988 when Lockerbie the town became Lockerbie the disaster. Pan Am Flight 103 bound for New York exploding and shattering out of the sky. All of those on board were killed and a further 11 lives were claimed on the ground. A crater, all that was left of Lockerbie's Sherwood Crescent. Today it's returned to the ordinary street it was then. No sign of the devastation it suffered.
The names of all 270 victims are engraved in this memorial on the edge of town. A wreath laid today bears the simple message, your memories will always be cherished here.
Lockerbie wasn't the target of the terrorists who planned the bombing of Flight Pan Am 103, but it is the town that suffered its tragic consequences. The passing of the 20th anniversary is a time to reflect and move on. Debbie Edward, ITV News, Lockerbie.
Remembering Lockerbie 20 years on. On to the day's football now. Liverpool are 2 points clear at the top of the Premier League after a 1-1 draw at Arsenal. Robbie Keane secured the point after Robin van Persie gave the home side the lead. The position of Manchester City boss Mark Hughes looks increasingly precarious after West Brom's injury time winner kept his team in the relegation zone. Newcastle beat Spurs with a last-minute goal from Damian Duff. And Celtic move 4 points clear in the SPL after a 3-0 win at Falkirk. Finally, a memorable Christmas chart was unveiled tonight. For the first time, two versions of the same song took the top two places. In fact, reality TV dominated the top five selling singles with X Factor winner Alexandra Burke leading the way. Phil Ray Smith explains.
She sung Hallelujah and It Turns Out with Reason, now officially with the fastest selling single by a female solo artist ever, way outselling her closest rival with 576,000 copies.
Alexandra Burke, the X Factor winner of 2008, is this year's Christmas number one.
It's ridiculous. I'm actually in the biggest shock right now. I don't even know what to do with myself, but I'm just so happy.
It's doubly historic because this year, for the first time in 51 years, and the first time ever at Christmas, the same song is at number two, this version by the late singer Jeff Buckley, thanks to downloads alone, but mainly thanks to the hype around the X Factor winner's version. It's testament to the power of Simon Cowell, you could argue the man that stole Christmas.
The X Factor seems to have killed Christmas betting, that's the first thing. You know, in years gone by, that was a huge market for the bookies, and now it's just a runaway favourite every single year that X Factor's there. But the interesting thing this year is that they've covered Hallelujah, and I think two of the top five certainly are Hallelujah, which is incredible for artists who've gone before.
And not just that, his act Leona Lewis is at number three, and Peter Kay's talent show spoof Geraldine, not signed by Simon Cowell, but owing a large debt to him, is at five. If Cliff Richard was once the king of the charts at Christmas, today it is surely Cowell. Phil Ray Smith, ITV News.
And that's all for now from me and the weekend team. Good night.
If the sun declines to shine with Sheila's wheels, you're doing fine.
Where the skies are grey or blue, our car insurance covers you.
Hello again. It's a very windy picture indeed across the northern parts of Scotland as we move through the night. With gusts up to 75 miles an hour, the Met Office have issued a flash weather warning, which is in force until around 2 a.m. So looking ahead to the rest of the night, you can see it is going to be a mostly cloudy picture, patchy light rain in places, and incredibly mild once again. And we continue with those mild temperatures as we move into the start of the brand new week. But we also continue with the cloud and rain as well. The most significant rain there towards the north of Scotland, but at least the wind's dying down quite significantly. Now looking ahead then to the next few days, it's a fairly similar story, I think. Continuing mostly cloudy, but becoming generally dry. And also as we move towards Christmas Day itself, it is going to be turning less mild. That's it from me. I'll see you tomorrow. Good night.
Where the skies are grey or blue, Sheila's whiskers cover you.
When will the digital TV switchover happen? To find out this and more, go to itvlocal.com/switchover.